Hello students, welcome back to Narayana Digital Classes. Today we will be solving the assignment number 27 on the topic solutions. Let's move on to the assignment. Here the first question: the osmotic pressure of a decimolar solution of urea at 27 degrees centigrade is. So we need to find a osmotic pressure of a solution which has concentration decimolar, right? So the formula for the osmotic pressure, pi equal to CRT. So here pi is osmotic pressure, we need to find. So first C is concentration, that is how much they have given, that is decimolar. Decimolar means 1 by 10 molar, 1 by 10 molar, that is equal to 0.1 molar. Concentration is 0.1 molar, and R equal to gas constant, that is equal to 0.0821 liter atmosphere, mole inverse kelvin inverse. R equal to gas constant, that is that value is 0.0821 liter atmosphere, mole inverse and kelvin inverse. And next one, T equal to temperature. So how much temperature they have given? The temperature is 27 degrees centigrade. So if we convert into kelvins, plus 273 27 plus 273 that is equal to 300 kelvin. We need to find the osmotic pressure, that is pi. We don't know the pi value. This is osmotic pressure. Just substitute these values in this formula, then we will get the osmotic pressure, pi equal to concentration 0.1 mole per liter into R gas constant, 0.0821 liter atmosphere, mole inverse kelvin inverse into temperature 300 kelvin, Now cancel the liter and liter will be cancelled, and mole will cancel, and kelvin inverse and kelvin will cancel. We will get the answer pi equal to 2.463 atmosphere. So the partial pressure of decimolar solution of urea at 27 degrees centigrade is 2.463 atmosphere. The correct option is first option. Let's move on to the next problem. Here the second question: a 5% solution of cane sugar, its cane sugar molecular weight they have given, that is 342, is isotonic with 1% solution of substance X. The molecular weight of X is. So here we need to find the molecular weight of X. Molecular weight of X is substance which is contained 1% solution. So here we need to focus in one point, that is isotonic. So what is meant by isotonic? Isotonic means there are two different solution which has same osmotic pressure. Same osmotic pressure with two different solutions, right? Here what are the two different solution? One solution of cane sugar, that is 5%, and another solution of 1%, right? They have given two solutions. One is 5% solution, another one is 1% solution. So what is meant by 5% solution? So 5% solution, 5% cane sugar solution cane sugar solution one 5% cane sugar solution, so weight of this 5% cane sugar solution is 5 grams cane sugar, 5 grams cane sugar dissolved in 100 grams of solution. 5 grams cane sugar dissolved in 100 grams of solution. And next solution is 1% cane sugar solution. Here the cane sugar weight of cane sugar is 1 gram, right? So both the solutions are present at isotonic condition. That means the osmotic pressure of both the solutions are equal. So pi 1 equal to pi 2, the osmotic solution, the osmotic pressure of solution 1, the cane sugar solution 1 and cane sugar solution 2, right? Both are equal. So C1RT equal to C2RT. C1RT which is equal to C2RT. So here the gas constant and temperature is constant, so those will be cancelled, and the final is concentration 1 equal to concentration 2. Concentration 1 equal to concentration 2. So here what is the concentration? Weight of substance 1 by molecular weight of substance. Molecular weight of substance 1. In the same way, weight of substance 2 by molecular weight of substance 2. Molecular weight of substance 2. We know the weight of substance 1, that is 5 grams, and cane sugar weight they have given, that is 342. So 5 by 342 which is equal to weight of substance 2, that is 1 gram. We don't know the molecular weight of substance, that is x, we need to find. So molecular weight of x we need to find, that is x. So x equal to 342 into 1 by 5. So if you solve this one, you will get 68.5. so the molecular weight of substance 2, which is x, equal to 68.5. So the correct option is third option. Clear? Let's move on to the next question. Here the question: the osmotic pressure of 5% mass by volume solution of cane sugar at 150 degrees centigrade. The molar mass of cane sugar is 342 is. So here we need to find the osmotic pressure of cane sugar solution which has the concentration 5% mass by volume. 5% mass by volume. So cane sugar at 150 degrees centigrade, right? So we know the osmotic pressure formula. Pi equal to CRT, right? Here they have the concentration C equal to, what is the concentration here? 5%. 5% mass by volume. Mass by volume. Right? That means 5 grams cane sugar dissolved in 100 ml solution. 100 ml solution. Clear? Next, they have given temperature, that is 150 degrees centigrade, which will convert into kelvins, 423 kelvins, and R equal to gas constant. R equal to gas constant, that is 0.0821 liter atmosphere mole inverse Kelvin inverse, right? Let's substitute all these values in this formula. Here we need to concentrate one thing. Here the concentration they have given in the mass by volume percentage. Then the formula for the in terms of volume, the pi V equal to NRT. pi v equal to n RT, right? So here, in number of moles, n equal to weight by molecular weight. Then substitute those values in this formula, pi equal to nRT by V, that is n equal to molecular weight of substance is 5 grams, weight of substance 5 grams, 5 by 342 into 0.0821 into 423 by what is that volume, that is 100 ml, so 0.1 liter. If you solve this one, you will get the answer 5.07. so the osmotic pressure is 5.07 atmospheres, right? So the correct option is second option. Let's move on to the next question. Here the question, the relationship between osmotic pressure at 273 Kelvin when 10 grams of glucose P1, 10 grams of urea P2 and 10 grams of sucrose P3 are dissolved in 250 ml of water is. So here we need to find the osmotic pressure of three different solutions which has same concentration, right? So the osmotic pressure formula is pi equal to CRT. In terms of volume, we can written it as pi V equal to nRT. So here pi V equal to weight of substance by molecular weight of substance into RT, right? So if you see the solutions, each and every solution volume is same, that is 250 ml, and temperature also same, that is 273 Kelvin. So P1, there are three solutions, P1, P2 and P3. P1, P2, P3. And three solutions, volume is same, V, and temperature also same, right? Clear? So the only difference between the three solution is molecular weight of the three substances are different. So glucose molecular weight is different. So glucose molecular weight equal to 180 and urea molecular weight, that is equal to 60, and sucrose molecular weight, that is equal to 342. Right? If you see the formula, the relation between osmotic pressure and molecular weight, the osmotic pressure always inversely proportional to molecular weight of substance. So if anyone have high molecular weight, they has the less osmotic pressure. If you see, you can observe the osmotic pressure of three solutions, the relation is P3 greater than P1 greater than P2. P3 greater than P1 greater than P2. So the correct option is second option. Clear? Let's move on to the next problem. Here the last problem. Among the following pairs of solution, isotonic solution are, right? They have given different four options, different solutions. So the concentrations are different and they have different pairs, right? We need to find the isotonic solution. What is isotonic solution? There is two different solution which have the same osmotic pressure. So here they did not given the osmotic pressure, but how can we find the isotonic solution? So here the osmotic pressure formula is pi equal to pi equal to I CRT. So here I is 1/2 factor. I equal to 1/2 factor. If any one of the pair have same 1/2 factor, they are isotonic in osmotic pressures, right? So if you see, all the options, the fourth option is 0.1 molar calcium nitrate and 0.1 molar sodium sulfate. So the 1/2 factor for the calcium nitrate and sodium sulfate are same. So the correct option is fourth option. Clear? With this, I come to the end of the session. Thank you very much.